Good morning. I trust that you guys are having a good week, and I especially want to wish that you would have a great Easter break, safe travels wherever you're going home. Also, there's an announcement that didn't get on the screen, and again, with the weather and the sports teams, not sure whether or not they're having games. There is going to be a softball game today at 3:30 against Aquinas, so I would encourage you to be there. We haven't done this for a bit, and I always want to be reminded as to why we're doing this. Again, you know, we could have the junior high thought and think we do this because we have to, but the opportunity for 1,000 brothers and sisters in the Lord to gather together in one place in the midst of all that we're experiencing in our lives and in our relationships, things that we anticipate for the future, the things that we look back and see in our past, and we have the opportunity to gather together in the name of Christ. And I'd just like to invite you to read this with me. We gather together in the name of Jesus Christ to worship him, to hear his word spoken as he seeks to conform us to his image, to write his word upon the tablet of our hearts, and to transform us by the renewing of our minds for his glory. Lydia's got an announcement.
All right, well, election season has come to a close. And at first, I want everybody to give a warm round of applause for all of our candidates. They did an awesome job running. And now, without further ado, I would like to introduce to you the 2013-2014 SGA President and Vice President, Stephen Halacki and Rachel Boggs.
Thank you, guys. Rachel cannot be here today. She's a little bit under the weather, so I would appreciate your prayers for her. But from the both of us, we want to thank you for your support. And we cannot wait to serve you and hear your ideas for next year. So please stand with me and let us pray. Heavenly Father, God, thank you so much for today. God, thank you for this school year so far, and Lord, for the closing that is coming to. God, I pray that as with all the hustle and bustle and all the work and exams coming up, God, I just pray that you would help us to stay calm, to be in your word, to be in prayer, to be in your presence, oh God. And I pray that as we go through today, Lord, with this chapel service, Lord, that you just be with the chapel band, that you just anoint them and use their gifts and their talents for you, oh God, to minister to us, to be pleasing and a pleasing aroma to you. God, I pray that you'd open up the hearts, minds, and souls that are here. May we be receptive to your word, to your spirit, Heavenly Father, God. And I just want to pray blessings on this whole place, on this campus, on the professors, and on all the other workers. And we just want to accept and expect what you have for us today. And we just want to ask you all these things in Jesus' name. Amen.
Listen to what it has to say in the scriptures. When Jesus had cried out again in a loud voice, he gave up his spirit. At that moment, the curtain of the temple was torn in two from top to bottom. The earth shook and the rocks split. The tombs broke open, and the bodies of many holy people who had died were raised to life. They came out of the tombs, and after Jesus' resurrection, they went into the holy city and appeared to many people. After the Sabbath, at dawn on the first day of the week, Mary Magdalene and the other Mary went to look at the tomb. There was a violent earthquake, for an angel of the Lord came down from heaven and, going to the tomb, rolled back the stone and sat on it. His appearance was like lightning, and his clothes were white as snow. The guards were so afraid of him that they shook and became like dead men. The angel said to the women, "Do not be afraid, for I know that you are looking for Jesus who was crucified. He is not here. He has risen." So today we celebrate Jesus Christ, who was crucified and buried, but raised again on the third day according to the scriptures. Please join with us in singing.
Clap your hands, all ye people, and shout unto God with a voice of triumph. Oh, 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 with a voice of triumph. Oh, 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 you are the everlasting God.
Thank you. for blood satisfied her hunger was. Billows calmed on raging seas, the souls of men she craved. Sun and moon from balcony turned their head in disbelief. Precious love would taste the sting, disfigured and disdained. On Friday a thief, on Sunday a king. Laid down in grief, but woke with the keys. Hell on that day, the firstborn of the slain. The man Jesus Christ laid dead in his grave. Oh, 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 oh. So 3 days in darkness left, morning sun of righteousness, who rose to shame the throes of death, overturn his rule. Our daughters and his sons and men, who paid out their dues again. The debt of blood they owed was rent, the day old and new. On Friday a thief, on Sunday a king. Laid down in grief, but awoke with the keys. Hell on that day, the firstborn of the slain. The man Jesus Christ laid death in his grave. Death in his grave. Death in his grave. Death in his grave. Thank you. relent until you have it all. My heart is yours.
I'll set you as a seal upon my heart, as a seal upon my arm. For there is love that is as strong as death.
Preaching a baptism of repentance for the forgiveness of sins. The whole Judean countryside and all the people of Jerusalem went out with him. Confessing their sins, they were baptized by him in the Jordan River. This was his message. Prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight the paths for him. Every valley shall be filled in, every mountain and hill made low. The crooked roads shall become straight, the rough way smooth, and all mankind will see God's salvation. After me will come one more powerful than I, whose sandals I am not worthy to stoop down and untie. I baptize you with water, but he will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and with fire. He will ignite the kingdom, life, a fire, the Holy Spirit within you, changing you from the inside out. He will clean sweep, he will do a clean sweep of your lives. He will place everything true in its proper place before God. Everything false he'll put out with the trash to be burned. Therefore, let us be grateful for receiving a kingdom that cannot be shaken. And thus, let us offer to God acceptable worship with reverence and awe. For our God is a consuming fire. as we rest in his presence, hear what the Lord has to say. I will rescue those who love me. I will protect those who trust in my name. When they call on me, I will answer. I will be with them in trouble. I will rescue and honor them. Come to me, all of you who are weary and carry heavy burdens, and I will give you rest. Take my yoke upon you. Let me teach you, because I am humble and gentle at heart, and you will find rest for your souls. For my yoke is easy to bear, and the burden I give you is light. So be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid, and do not panic before them. For the Lord your God will personally go ahead of you. He will neither fail you nor abandon you. Imagine that God, our Father, is singing this to you. He is inviting you into his embrace. So embrace him.
Thank you.
thank you so much for your promise to never leave us or forsake us, that we can come to you and find rest. God, you are everything, everything that we need. We thank you so much for the love and the grace that you pour out on us. God, I pray that we would be open to that. That you would meet us in this place.
Here in the secret.
darkness you shine. Out of the ashes we rise. There's no one like you. None like you. Our God is greater. Our God is stronger. God, you are higher than any other. Our God is healer, awesome in power. Our God, our God. Turn into wine, open the eyes of the blind. There's no one like you, there's none like you. Into the darkness you shine, out of the ashes we rise. There's no
forever and die. praises rise, all the glory for all of time. Jesus, Savior, forever and ever. This is love. Jesus came and died and gave his life for us. Let our voices rise. Be